Then we can go close to open, which will be normal 8 count. Triple step, 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 triple step. If we do the chastenized version, we have rock step, kick step, kick, and kick step, which leads out into our rock step. So if we're out here and we're doing a normal 8 count swing out, we're going to go 1, 2, triple step, 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 triple step. If we're doing the Charleston version, we have rock step, kick step, kick, and kick step, rock step, kick step, and kick step, rock step. We have open to close. So our open close 8 count is a lindy circle, step, step, triple step. If we do our Charleston version, we have rock step, kick, and kick step, rock step. And we're back to closed. So these moves start with a basic from open or from closed, and they have a finish with a two open or two closed. So obviously, if you're starting closed, we rock step, kick step, and we've got this weight on this foot, and then next thing we did, which we would use that for, is repeat it. Kick, kick, and kick, kick, and kick. Kick step, and we can come out of that whenever we're ready. If we're in the repeaters, so we go rock step, kick step, ba-da, 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 rock step. We can allow our follow to come out when we're ready, and because she's doing the kick step, she will fly away from us because all of the turning, the rotational energy, she'll land on that foot, which is her left foot, and then of course we can naturally lead her into that nice big stretchy rock step. And it is a nice big stretchy boing moment rock step. The other kind of repeater that we did is a down the line, so we can go rock step, kick, and kick, and whenever we're ready, we finish the move. We take a follow over onto the back foot, and then just continue that into a nice rock step. So the other thing we did was hand to hands. We'll just do a basic entrance, which was a revision from the first class, which will be rock step, kick step, rock step, hand to hand. Da, 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 da. We're going to use the timing of the variation where we miss, we go rocks. Kick step, kick step, kick step, catch. Kick step, catch. Kick step, catch. Now, if we just do one miss, we're going to go kick step, miss, kick step, catch. Kick turn, kick step, kick turn, kick step, kick turn, kick step. And the exit is the same. Kick turn, miss, kick step, catch. So that's that move. The key points are you've got it. Guys, we have to turn ourselves a little bit early because we've got to get a nice early connection here so that we can push into that. We're kicking backwards and we're kicking and we're slowing ourselves down and follow. And when we change direction, we are pulling off of our follow and pushing off that hand turns us, gives us that. So when I push off this hand, there's only one way I can turn. I turn naturally that way. And that is that move. You guys can try other things like you can speed yourself up and you can try a different kind of catch. You can do all sorts of interesting variations. If you speed yourself up, slow yourself down, you can catch your follow on front of her hand, back of her hand. Try some different things and see what you end up.
There really are a lot of variations to this. And as a follow, all you need to know is your basic footwork. And you just keep doing it. Always have your frame available for him. And whenever he's going to apply pressure, which is particularly hard in this backwards position, you need to apply pressure back, because if you let that arm go, he's not going to have the strength to push off to then turn him and in turn turn me. So
follows are
quite a technical.
Follows are allowing the legs to stop, and my job is to stop her by catching her, and her job is to let me stop her. either of you stop yourselves and then you push off the floor, then the move won't work. We won't have the same energy and the same